Okay, so before we begin, I just want to point out that I'm a fucking retard and I can't read the comments properly. And I got the loadout a little bit wrong because for the first half of the, you know, the little montage that you are always seeing, it's wrong because I am using the muzzle brake instead of flash suppressor and I am using CMAG instead of the extended magazine. Yeah, I'm still a human being, mistakes happen, and yeah, you will see. So once we have this out of the way, I want to thank you, Semper Paratus, for submitting this loadout, and sorry because I fucked up a little bit with it. You know, mistakes happened, and yeah, I'm still a human being, so yeah. And also the footage that you're gonna be seeing still contains a little bit of the wrong loadout, so that's one thing worth mentioning. Another thing that is worth mentioning, this is a sick loadout. I really had a blast with it. I think I will upload some of the gameplay just so you guys can see how awesome this loadout is in CQC. Basically, this is a beast weapon for team deathmatch, and maps like Tomsk, Gallery, and also you know, CQC maps, basically. So yeah, very effective because the ready time is ridiculously low. You don't even have this circle that you you know, ready time counter, as you probably could name it. I don't know, but you know, with every LMG that we are using, there is a little circle in the middle of the screen. That's this ready time counter, and with this loadout, it doesn't exist simply. And the one another thing that it's worth mentioning, I have already played with it before. You Semper had submitted, and yeah, so I didn't had to buy anything for this loadout, maybe with exception for this flash suppressor, because I'm using it normally. I'm using MG36 with muzzle brake just to get some control back, because it kicks like a mule, and you really it's not as hard as M240 to control, but it's still quite a challenge to you know, to unleash this beast. Maybe not unleash, but you know, keep it under control. You have very high recoil. Unfortunately, grip helps a bit, and so yeah, it's quite a challenge. But I think it wasn't hard challenge for me. You know, I know the weapon very well, and one thing that is worth mentioning, I am using too much of this, but whatever. Is that the MG36, in my opinion, is the most versatile botmaster weapon in... for sure this is the most versatile LMG, if not the most versatile gun in the game. That's because you can customize it for every map and every situation. Slap a long barrel in it and it will perform very well on long range maps. Slap a short barrel and grip, and you have CQC beast, as you can see. But I am again going to the recommendations, god damn it. So I think that's all I have to say about this. Let's go to the recommendations, what I will change. Okay guys, so welcome to the recommendations. Actually there is nothing really much to say about this customization. Maybe the few things that I would change is get the CMAG magazine. That's because running with 50 rounds on the support, it's not very much. And you know, usually with LMGs you have 100 rounds, and if you want to use this weapon as it was submitted by Semper, you need to switch your mind around using this extended magazine. Also, the second thing that I would change is to stick with the foldable stock one. That's because the render time is already very very good, and also the muzzle brake. But the control is it's much easier to control this weapon. So if you have problems, if you're struggling controlling this weapon, in this combination, that go ahead and just stick around this. And actually, that's how it is used in the real life. I think maybe not with the extended mag, but with the standard mag. And yeah, it looks absolutely awesome. I think it's not only this is the most versatile gun, at least LMG for now, but also it looks fucking amazing. And when it comes to the appearance of the LMGs, this is definitely my favorite one. So if you want to use this weapon in CQC, stick with the C-Mag, muzzle brake or thrust suppressor. It depends on the map, and also if you manage to control this weapon without thrust suppressor, without muzzle brake. This is the CQC loadout. Another thing you can, for the medium range, you can take the bipod. It's very effective. It's good. You can still use it. Actually, Dylan done one video about this this customization. Actually, not about this customization, but he used this gun in this way. You can use it, but how I usually run this weapon is either short barrel or the medium. That's because you can double shot and take out most of the recon. 60 damage, 58, but for the recons, they have less armor and they're more squishy, so they will take more damage than us with light attacks of 6. So it's for recons it's 60 body damage, so most of them will be down in the 2 shots in the body. And it also works in a long range very well. Basically control is very good. It's even comparable to the Type 95 public enemy. That's why I'm using more often this weapon over the Type 95. Just, I don't know, I like it more. That's something. But what's noticeable is the lack of the burst mode. If you want to use this like on the longer ranges, you have to either tap fire or switch to semi, and you will be golden. And you can use Phantom Skull with this weapon. I don't recommend this, but it makes sense because it's very accurate LMG, and it performs very well out of cover. So to conclude with CQC, grip, short barrel, and C-Mag, very good gun. It's even comparable to the special edition, a limited edition ABR. For CQC it's better because it has slightly more fire rate but slightly less damage, one less damage. Isn't that noticeable? You'll still drop people for less than 4 bullets in close quarters. And it's very good too. If you have limited edition, use this weapon in CQC combat. And if you want to do some long range shooting as well, just get the bipod for double stock one, just to get some reduce some of the read time, and the C-Mag of course, just to hold this fire as long as you can, as long as it's possible. That's all I think I have to say. Thank you again, Semper, for your submission. It's highly appreciated. Of course, Thank you guys so much for watching, for all of those likes under the every video, and also for all of those comments. It really makes me happy to, you know, to check out how is my channel doing, and seeing all of those likes and comments really makes me happy. And yeah, if you have any idea about any Lota Bot, leave them down below. I think you, so far you know what to do. But if you are new one and you like this video and have an idea, go ahead and watch the episode number 0, that everything is explained there. So yeah, I hope you guys have a nice day, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye!